Hi guys, this is Dr. Samali Azad. What we're trying to do here, discover some of the structures associated with the sense of balance and sense of hearing, and the organ is going to be your ear. Looking at the ear structure, you can see the visible parts right in this part that you can see the helix and also the anti-helix part. Then you have this couple of bumps known as the targus and anti-targus, and of course your earlobe that is located there. Sound waves are going to be traveling from outside through this opening known as the external auditory meatus and enter right into the temporal bone part of the skull. Now, if I remove some of the bony structure, now we can kind of visualize the structures that are associated with the sense of hearing and balance. Your ear is divided into three sections. The first section is going to be from the opening part all the way to this membrane known as the tympanic membrane or eardrum, and the channel that is right here, the opening, is known as auditory meatus, external auditory meatus. From there, the sound wave is going to be hitting the tympanic membrane, and vibration from that one is going to be transmitted into the middle or a middle ear that is located right here, and are going to be three auditory ossicles associated with that one. The first one, known as malleus, that is attached right into the tympanic membrane and is going to be transmitting the vibration to the next one, known as the incus. And from the incus, vibration is going to be transmitted to the next one, known as the stapes. Stapes is going to be transmitting the information in form of vibration right into the next part, which is known as the inner part of the ear. Couple of structures associated with the middle part of ear. Number one is going to be this opening known as the eustachian tube, which extends from the middle ear all the way to your esophagus, and it's good for decompression of the sounds. And this one that is right here, this muscle is known as the tensor tympani, and another muscle that sits right at the foot plate part right alongside here is known as stapes muscle. The function of these two muscles is by contracting, pull the bony structures away and would not allow the fracture of the bone to occur in case that suddenly that you hear a loud sound. The sound is going to be entering through this oval shaped structure known as the oval window right into this part. Now, for a sense of hearing, we're going to be dealing with this snail-looking structure known as the cochlea. And as you can see inside of it, is going to be interconnection of several passageways. This here, which is showing the cochlea, it will show that you can see there are one channel or one opening or one passage inside the other one and produce that kind of circular motion that is associated with it. Now, if I open this part, now you can see that the things that are associated with it is a little bit easier to be able to discover. These are the chambers. There are three of them. This one is known as scala tympani. Then you have the scala vestibuli. And right down the center, you have the scala media. Scala media, within it, you have your organ of the hearing or organ of corte, which is going to be converting the mechanical sound into some kind of chemical activity, which is the action potential, and ultimately cause formation of the nerve impulses through the nerve impulses right alongside here that are known as the spiral ganglion. And all the spiral ganglion from different parts connect to one another, and they are going to be producing your cochlear nerve. The other thing that's also associated with the inner ear are going to be your sense of balance or vestibular part, composed of several parts. Number one is going to be this semicircular canal, three of them that are sitting kind of perpendicular to one another. As semicircular canals, they come down, you can see there's a little small swelling there. This is known as the ampulla part of it. Right below the ampulla, I'm going to have the utricle, and below that one, I have the saccules. The saccules is the one that controls the vertical movements, such as up and down, going up and down the elevator. The utricle is the one that is very important for linear kind of movement that you have there. And of course, this semicircular canal are the one that controlling your body rotation in all the axes that you have. ultimately, all the nerve impulses are generated and is by way of the vestibular nerve is going to be exiting and going to the proper part of the brain. Combination of the cochlear and the vestibular nerve, they're going to be producing your cranial nerve number 8, known as the vestibulocochlear nerve. The other thing that also that you should be aware of, that presence of this little hole right here. This is known as the round window, because as the decompression happens alongside here, the sound wave is going to enter through this part, and ultimately the excess has to come out and down your throat going down. This round window allows the decompression that happens, so the sound wave does not stay constantly within this part, which may cause a little bit of problem. Within your semicircular canal, as you can see in this one, it's nothing more than one chamber that is located inside the other one. The outer chamber is known as the bony labyrinth, and the inside chamber is known as the membranous labyrinth. There are fluid circulating within this area, and our fluids are the one that produce your sense of balance, helping with the sense of your balance. The fluid that is inside of this membranous labyrinth is known as the endolymph. The fluid that between the bony and the membranous labyrinth is known as the prelymph. And they are the one that helping with the sense of balance for us. All right. I hope that you found it to be helpful, and thank you for watching.